Let's now create an automation using REST in JSON format. Most web applications use REST over SOAP like Facebook and HubSpot. Let's get started. In the Web API tool, select HTTP client. This will open the HTTP request wizard. Let's use OpenWeather Map as an example. Let's use the REST API in JSON format. Let's click on this and let's copy this link. Then we'll paste the link in the endpoint field. As you can see, the link already includes the parameters. So if we run the preview response, it will give us result. Now if we remove the parameters and run it, it will give us an error message. Let's go back to the Request Builder tab. Let's add the parameters manually by clicking the Add Parameter button under the Parameters dropdown. Remember the extension of our web service URL? The letter Q is the parameter name, so we will put it here. The parameter value is what next to the equal sign. That will be London, UK. For the request method, we will use get since we will be fetching data from the service. There's no attachment for this one and no authentication since this API is public. Okay, let's preview the response. As you can see, the request URL automatically adds the parameters at the end. The structure of JSON has some similarities with the XML format. The root element is located in the outside part of the structure and it encloses the child element under it. Let's generate this activity. Alright, let's go ahead and review the values in the properties panel. In the input section, here we have the URL of the service, the method which is currently set to get, and here's the parameters which currently have a default values. And here we have other settings like advanced authentication, which are mostly required by commercial web applications. In the previous video with XML, we have added the serialized XML activity. There is also an equivalent activity for JSON, which is added automatically by the wizard. We'll rename the output variable for the HTTP client. Let's put in REST response. Let's change the scope to main. It automatically changes the input variable for the deserialized JSON activity. Let's rename the output variable of the JSON object to JSON document. Let's also change the scope to main. Let's add a write line activity. Let's put in the variable of the string output of JSON activity, which is REST response. Let's run it. So here's the output in a string format retrieved from the OpenWeather map. Let's say we wanted to retrieve specific data from this content. If we want to capture the temperature in a certain area, we can retrieve it by using its root and child element. In this case, it will be under main, temp. Let's add another write line activity. The format will be the JSON object, which is JSON document. Then we enclose the root element. Next will be the child element. Then we convert the output of the string format by adding dot to string. Let's run it. There's a result. Well, it's currently in Kelvin. Let's do a simple math by converting it to Celsius. The formula for Celsius is equal to Kelvin minus 273. We can only perform math calculations if the current value is in a number format. We'll use the keyword cn to convert the current value to integer, then we can subtract 273 from it. Let's remove first the .toString keyword, then we'll include the current statement into a cn. This is the time we can put in minus 273 at the end. Then we enclose it again so we can convert the output number back to string. That's it, let's run it. Perfect! The temperature now in London is 10 degrees Celsius. There you have it. Say goodbye to a costly and slow process of modifying API codes and use UiPath Web API automation at your advantage. Thanks for watching.